Okay, this is to describe the sound of the guitar using the mathematical ideas of sine waves. That's the mathematical model. I'm not going to use very many formulas here. There are plenty of them out there if you want them. This will show how mathematics is used to give an approximate description and understanding of the guitar. The string's energy is partially transformed into the energy of the sound wave. That's the model. Most of this will apply to electric as well, a bit differently. Model has to describe the energy of the string, also the energy of the guitar, and the sound wave energy from multiple strings plucked at the same time. And finally, if I can do it, I would like to relate it to the written music. A mathematical description starts with the circular rotation, which projects onto that sine wave. Underneath is the relative air pressure, and that would be a tuning fork or any partial of a complex wave. A harmonic series of those sine waves are added up to become the sound wave. And here are the perfect fifth and the octave, and the derivation from the string. Now, you can break down that complex wave into its component parts by the Fourier transform, which is a multiplication process. And that'll give you the relative strength of each of those frequencies. It's the quality which makes the sound of each instrument unique. And you can derive the relative strength at any particular point in time. First, a quick look at how waves are added. If they have the same frequency and starting point, you'll just get a larger amplitude. Different frequency waves have additions and subtractions, and if you start with the harmonic series, you rather quickly take on the shape of the plucked string. Daniel Bernouli first suggested the idea, but apparently he wasn't rigorous enough. Today we call it the Fourier series. Now, this kind of rotational imagery is a little bit better for the internet. What we're interested in is the sum of all the rotations, and that would be the Y value here. If the imagery is moved back and forth along the string length and reflected at the endpoints, the red dot here will trace out the approximate shape of the string. And as the higher harmonics drop off, the string tends towards the shape of the fundamental and finally comes to a rest. You can also trace out the sound wave in air with this kind of image. You set the curve in motion, and down below you'll see the changes in the relative air pressure. To get multiple strings, just tie two sets of harmonic circles together. And now a short overview of the multiplication process for the transform. You multiply the value of each wave at the same point along the horizontal. With waves of the same frequency, you'll get an all positive symmetrical shape you can easily find the area of. Multiplying waves of different frequencies always turn out to have a zero value. So you multiply the entire complex wave by the harmonic series with a unit value amplitudes, one at a time. For the fundamental, you get a smooth, positive wave symmetrical about pi. You get an approximate area with this jigsaw puzzle approach, confirmed by clicking the integration button on a graphing calculator. The upper partials are more complicated, but the process is similar. And you do need a formula to relate the natural harmonics to the guitar's logarithmic scale.